Welcome back to the Beverly Hilton, the Burj Griffin Hotel in Beverly Hills, California, for the 12th Annual Soap Opera Awards.
Reba is a party girl who's out for fun. Alan is a tough, ruthless businessman.
Here are Springfield's own Marla and Donald Trump. From Guiding Light, Kim Zimmer and Ron Rain.
Here's a thumbnail sketch of our nominees for Outstanding Younger Lead Actress.
One is being terrorized by her ex-husband's wife. Another has a mother-in-law who tried to poison her. The third has a mother who slept with her husband.
These three must be a real hoot at family reunions.
The nominees for Outstanding Younger Lead Actress are Christine on The Young and the Restless. The Legal Eagle, who is courted by two men, Laura Lee Bell.
Lily on As the World Turns. Her world crashed around her when her husband's plane went down. Martha Byrne.
From All My Children. Her husband took her money and her mother took her husband, Kelly Ripa.
And the winner is... Ripa! Kelly Ripa! From All My
It's a first. I'm at a loss for words. Okay, I'd like to thank the nice man for helping me up the stairs. That buffet, oh, jeez. I'd like to thank Agnes Nixon, first of all, for creating the character of Haley, and Felicia Monet-Bear for trusting me to do the job. You should be sainted. My second family and all my children, I love you guys. Mark Consuelos. Oh, I want to thank the writers for writing all those kissing scenes, too, because they're really good. My family at home for all their support. I've got to wrap it up. If I forgot anybody, I'm sorry. All my friends, love you, thanks.
Our next presenters first met on General Hospital, and now, actually, they're married in real life. In fact, they've been married for over a good 5 years now.
Well, imagine that. Two actors with a 5-year marriage? That's over 50 in real people years. Dr. Burns from Melrose Place and Felicia from General Hospital, Christina and Jack Wagner. This year's nominees for Hottest Romance consists of two couples in a trio.
So let's take a look at their work.
I can love you like that. I would make you my world. Put heaven and earth. If you were my girl, I would give you my heart. Be all that you need. Show you your
The nominees for Hottest Romance are Noah and Julie on All My Children. He came to her emotional and literal rescue and made her forget about her pain. Keith Hamilton Cobb and Sidney Penney.
Taylor, Ridge, and Brooke in The Bold and the Beautiful. He was supposed to be designing clothes, not putting his designs on two women. That's Hunter Tylo, Ron Moss, and Catherine Kelly Lang.
And Matt and Vanessa on Guiding Light. Everybody disapproved of their romance until they proved it could stand the test of time. That's Kurt McKinney and Maeve Kincaid.
And the winner is... Keith Hamilton Cobb and Sidney Penney.
Speak for me, love.
Oh, I can't speak for you. This is wonderful. I think if I had to speak for both of us, I would say that we are honored to be on this show. We've been at a lucky table tonight, and Agnes, you must be our lucky charm. You have set all this in motion, and we are thankful for it so much. And,
To the viewers of daytime TV, and especially those of all my children, this choice speaks volumes more than you know. And to our producer, Felicia Minet-Bear, thank you.
We're down to the home stretch now. Leader of Fave Show, but first we have a very special presentation.
Yes, we do. It's the prestigious Editor's Award, and to tell us about it, here's Soap Digest's Editor-in-Chief, Lynn Leahy.
Tonight's Editor's Award goes to a legendary writer who for more than 40 years has made us cry, laugh, and think. In fact, she has written for or created 6 of the 10 current daytime dramas. To tell us more about one of the soap world's biggest talents, please welcome her biggest fan and one of daytime's brightest stars, Susan Lucci.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Lynn. I'm here to honor a woman who quite literally puts words in my mouth. The creative force behind all my children, Agnes Nixon. Agnes, some special guests want to offer their congratulations.
A lot of people don't know that I, Oprah Winfrey, once starred on All My Children. Well, I shouldn't say starred exactly. You know, when I was an anchor woman in Baltimore, I had an assignment to cover the behind-the-scenes goings-on at All My Children. And while I was there, the producers offered me a part on the show. I was so excited because I watched the show every single day, no matter where I was, since college. And I figured that once they saw me on camera, soap, stardom, here I come. I thought I could be Erica's best friend or have a hot, steamy romance with Tad, you know, the first kind of interracial love in Pine Valley. But what happens? I get 6 lousy word. 6. What was I supposed to do with that? Of course, Agnes, you could ask me to guest star on the show now, but sorry, I'm sort of busy. Oh, and Agnes, coincidentally, on tomorrow's Oprah, we're doing a show on soap opera creators who forget their friends. Seriously, you did open the doors for daytime TV to discuss and tackle serious and important issues, and for that, many of us in the talk show arena owe you a debt of thanks. So congratulations, Miss Agnes, on this very special honor. You truly deserve it.
Daytime fans still come up and want to talk about Karen Woolrich. And in one life, Agnes, you created one amazing and inspiring show. I'm so honored to be a part of that program's fine history. And I'm equally honored to say to you, thank you for your contributions to daytime and continued success in your life. You deserve it.
You are our heart and our soul, as well as our life force. Congratulations.
Agnes, I'm so honored to be a part of your special tribute tonight. Well, for one thing, it gives me the chance to tell you something that I've wanted to say to you for many, many years. How in heaven's name could you kill off Jenny? I'm still ticked. I loved her. What were you thinking? Did you snap? I mean, I haven't stopped crying since 1984. And if you think I suffered, just imagine poor Greg. I mean, it can't be easy watching your wife blow up on a jet ski. I'm all right now. It gives me great pleasure to say congratulations, Agnes, on your very well-deserved award. And as all my children's number one fan, what else can I say? But I forgive you, and I'm so very glad we had this time together.
And now, if I might, a personal note about Agnes. Agnes has been entertaining and informing, enchanting and ensnaring audiences for quite some time now. Agnes, in the words of Cole Porter, you got that thing. And the song goes on to say, you got that thing that makes birds forget to sing. Oh, you got that thing all right. That thing that makes people schedule their classes and their work, their vacations, the birth of their babies, their entire lives around watching your shows. Now, if I were smart, I'd leave it at that, right? I mean, if Cole Porter couldn't come up with a lyric that more fully described the magic that certain people have that sets them apart from all others, well, who am I? But so many people stop me, and they ask me, what is Agnes Nixon really like? Tell me about Agnes Nixon. So I'll try. Oh, there is magic, all right. There's magic in the lady herself and magic in her writing. I think that Agnes Nixon actually works on an additional wavelength. I mean, how else can we explain all those incredible stories that she writes months and months before they ever appear in the headlines of our newspapers? And on a personal note, it was Agnes Nixon who predicted the birth of my first baby in real life. She predicted the exact month, the exact day, and that that baby would be a girl. She did this on her Ouija board, and I wasn't even pregnant yet. Well, in addition to Agnes's obvious intelligence and extremely hard work, and I mean ongoing, hands-on, creative hard work, there is her legendary sense of humor. Everyone who has ever worked with Agnes talks about it. You only have to be in her presence for 5 minutes to know it yourself. And besides, it shows. It shows in her writing. It's one of the things her audiences loves best about her. And it shows in the gleam in her eyes. It shines from her beautiful blue-eyed blonde face. And something I think would surprise a lot of people, because Agnes is such an enormous presence in this industry and has achieved such greatness. She is a perfect size 4. I mean, I'm guessing maybe it's a perfect size 2. But in any case, Agnes Nixon has more style in her little finger than most of us could ever hope to have in our entire beings in our entire lifetimes. Agnes, I want your clothes. Finally, there's one more thing that I'd like to say about Agnes. It's a word that isn't heard very often. Agnes has grace. Grace in the way she walks, grace in the way she talks, grace in the way she deals with the enormous demands of her career, grace in the way she keeps her family close, grace under pressure, grace in the way she writes her stories, how she weaves and interweaves her plots. Agnes, on behalf of everyone at home watching you tonight and every day, and on behalf of all of us in this room tonight, especially those of us who have been lucky enough to be handed one of your timely and timeless scripts, thank you for gracing us with your presence. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Agnes Nixon.
Waterproof.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so, Susan.
Boy, what a send-up.
Mm. Right? And thank you, Susan, for everything you've done. We've done together for 26 years now. It's been great. And I thank... How much time do I have? Very little, right? I thank particularly Lynn Leahy and all the staff of Soap Opera Digest for this really, truly great honor. But if it's a lifetime achievement, it's the achievement of many lifetimes, of many people in front of the camera and behind the camera, at the networks, who, and my own family, whom I know time won't permit my mentioning all their names, but I couldn't have done any of it without you, certainly not my family. And as we say on our show, this is for you kids, really. And there are a few people who are no longer with us, much to all our regret, whom I would like to name. The mother of us all, Erna Phillips. That wonderful radio and television producer who taught me so much, Walter Gorman. That wonderful television couple, Ted and Betty Corday. Those wonderful writers and human beings, Gordon Russell and Douglas Marlin. And our the three wonderful, beloved actors on All My Children, who have gone on, Kay Campbell, who was known as Grandma Kate, Hugh Franklin as Dr. Charles Tyler, and the ineffable Fra Heflin as Mona Kane Tyler, Erica's mother. And I've been warned that I don't have much time, so in the very brief moments that are left, I would like to thank a segment of our daytime world that I don't think gets heralded nearly enough. And that's our audience. If you people think we don't appreciate you, you're wrong. We know it's because you're there that we're here. We love getting your letters, because even if we can't answer them, because we do 200, each show does 260 episodes a year, so we stay pretty busy. But we read everyone we get from you, and even the ones that aren't so complimentary, because we know you care and you keep us on our toes. And it will always be a source of pride to us that you're there, that you care for us. And I think all of us here today, kids, should get up and thank our audience out there. Tell them how much they mean to us. Words of the great immortal Ralph Cramden, audience, you're the greatest. And tune in tomorrow. God bless us, everyone.
Just ahead, Keith Hamilton Cobb and women who steal everything, including your hearts.